mantra, wherever you are in a divine presence, believe me, you yourself are in a divine presence always, number one. There is no way you can segregate yourself from your soul or yourself. This is a very important point you have to understand. So, just keep your mind out of yourself. Use your mind as a tool. Mind is an instrument, mind is a tool for your other work. When it comes to spiritual work, don't allow your mind to mingle with your own self. That means you should have clarity, you should have clarity about where to use your mind, where not to use your mind. The general way the world operates is, from the past 35-40 years, is they mix the mind very casually with your spiritual world. The bhakti and the bhavana has been completely diluted from the past 30 years. For everything, the mind has been mixed in as a kind of a seasoning we do. With food, there is always the seasoning we do. Even in spiritual things, we have been very conveniently using the mind in everything spiritual. That is the major problem and drawback where we have been used to. When we use the mind in spiritual things, automatically the clarity of the mind does not come, or the segregation of the mind does not happen. That is the reason from past 35-40 years we have been only been worrying, worrying and worrying unnecessarily for that unknown future. Every day we have been worrying unnecessarily for that unseen future. What is going to happen tomorrow for me or my children or for my parents or whatsoever? This nagging fear is spoiling ourself from our true self itself. That means the bliss is not being generated, which is normally being generated, which has to be normally generated for Shant and Paramanand. We are not enjoying this factor at all. Only when there is music, or whenever we find some relaxation, there will always be music and there will be some peace of mind. Without music, we cannot find any kind of peace. Depending upon our culture, upon our age, educational background and the kind of a sanskar we have. That is why we should now, even bhajan arati, what we do is just to induce that bliss. But unfortunately, from past 40 years, when the bhajan arati begins, there is some kind of a bliss and shanti. When the bhajan arati stops, we are back into the normal old world where the mind takes over and the peace is lost. That is the problem with us human beings from the past 35 to 40 years. That is the reason you have to segregate every day. How do you segregate one day? Like how from the Britishers we have learned Saturday, Sunday and weekend. Likewise, I would like all of you to follow one particular holy day, either Friday or Saturday or Sunday, whatever is your convenience. On that day you shut yourself off from socializing and any kind of matter which is bugging you or which is bothering you. You have to keep one day just for your own self to enjoy that state of bliss and peace in you. Very important. Every day, even on a Sunday we work, even on a Sunday there is no peace. That is the problem. In fact, what is this, that lack of peace? For even every minute you work, even on a holiday, what happens? That much of peace is taken away from you. The moment this peace is taken out of you, you will all feel extremely bored in life. Most of you, most of us from the past, especially from 15 years, we have always been or having been accustomed to some kind of an activity in life. Activity brings only agitation in life. If you are always active, you become one day or the other very hyperactive. Without you knowing, you may be sitting calm, you may be having a good chair, you may be sleeping, but the moment you wake up, you feel bored in your life, at least for some time. Why? The boredom is nothing but the waste of the mental energy and the waste of transcendental energy. If you are feeling bored, that means you are very highly agitated and there has been a lot of expectations in your life. Knowingly, unknowingly, consciously, subconsciously. So you have to deal in the mind. Very important. Don't go and try to find some kind of an activity in your life. When Krishna Bhagavan created us, he made to us whatever has to be creative and active, that much we will be creative and active. What he doesn't want for us, he will not allow us to do also. As I told you, everything is providence based. It is not a coincidence in life. If you want to achieve peace, then for some time every day or at least a day every week, you have to see to it you are cut off from your phones, from your mind and any sort of activity. Even if you sleep, it is not a waste. At least your body is taking rest. At least your hyperactive mind is taking rest. That is the reason many of you in today's world, from the past 35 years, they are suffering some kind of an agitative mind. You should be a vegetative soul. That means you have to go on creating a sense of creativity in you. You should be a calm. Even calmness is very creative. Even tranquil is creative energy, healing energy. You should never forget this in the background. Calm yourself. No activity on this day. No activity. Switch off your phones. Allow all your family members to be there, but you can only be reachable by their presence. Today, the telephones are not making your own near and dear ones familiar or making their presence with you. When your family meet together, you exchange and cross-exchange energy, an energy of love and peace. Because all of you are connected with the soul, there is no cross, connected with telephone, there is no cross exchange of peaceful, healing and loving energy. That is why when out of mind, if you go out of sight or out of sight, it makes you feel go out of your near and dear one's mind. That is why companionship is the best solution for everything. No pressure at all. How do you find your company. The near and dear ones are not there. Find the divine company as your best. No more stress because of that. Always you should seek divine company, if not with your family members or your near and dear ones. Very important. Otherwise, you will always be stressful in life. There is always a stressful activity. From past 30 years, there is only activity of stress. It is not activity, as we call it. No. Only stressful activity. Even with friends, there is stressfulness. There is familiarity. Familiarity breeds contempt. And contempt is nothing but causes you a lot of stress. So, you have to relax. Just go and sit somewhere for half an hour, 10 minutes every day. Just be yourself. Don't even speak to your wife. Don't even speak to your husband. You like her company. You like his company. Just sit, both of you together. But no talking. Just sit and close your eyes and just try to meditate. Peaceful, healing energy will be created around both of you, if you are two of you. That's what you should be doing. No more stress, no more activity. And I always advise, no more TV. Every day cut off the TV. Whenever you are meditating, whenever you are just being alone, because providence brings about a lot of grace. Wherein coincidence brings out karma, and karma brings out coincidence of the unlawful or out of the active or negative peace energy. There should never be a negative peace around us. We should become the healing light always. You have to segregate yourself at least every day 10-15 minutes. This habit of watching the prime time once you are out of the world at 7:30, 8 o'clock, that too while having dinner, automatically you are creating poison around you. Because if you have this habit of watching the prime time or any time, news time and all that, that will automatically coincide, again I am using the word coincide with your dinner time. So what will you be doing? You are watching the TV and eating subconsciously or mechanically. When you are eating, it should be taken as a prasad. And you should see that all the other demigods or different forces of divinity, like the eyes, like the ears, like the mouth, should only be used for a divine activity. Even eating is healing. Even the art of eating is very, very healing. That is the reason we are partaking 3 times of food every day. Switch off the TV. Very, very important. What happens? So, instead of what we call a devika prasad, everything will be turned as poison. That is why don't partake poison. That is, don't watch TV, you will be partaking poison. Even the amrit gets converted into poison. You relish the taste. Whatever be the state of food, whatever be it a chapati, be it a roti, or be it rice, whatever be the rice, eat. And what time does it require? 5 to 10 minutes of your eating time, which is precious time for your health. So please don't hold the plate in your hand, watch TV and eat. Place it, sit on a table, sit on the floor, just 5-10 minutes, devote yourself for good, healthy eating. Because the poison that is created in the system by the mind. Even a healthy, amrit-like food gets converted into poison. These are all important healthy living habits. Without healthy living, how can you go and knock at the doors of divinity of your own soul or any other gods? Gods will never help you. Have you partaken prasad? Yes, I have. God is going to ask you. And then God asks you, how have you eaten it, my child? No, I have eaten it by watching TV. And what did you watch? Nothing. Nonsense. It can be sense also. So, have you even thought about me while you are eating? Because I have given you healing light and the amount of health I have given you. Have you understood and considered me as your friend? We say, no, I don't know, I cannot know, I don't know. Then why did you do it? Eating is a constituent of your own health, of your better living, of your better way, of healing inside. I have not taken it as prasad. Then I have only taken as rubbish, that's all. That means the health system fails and crumples. That is the reason, even at 40, even at 35, we have various health problems in today's life. It is not only pollution. No. It is not the proper gravitation of the food that has been essentially given to us. The power of food to digest has been given to us not by our digestive systems, but by God Himself. Be it one chapati, or be it two, or be it three, that kind of a bhavana we should eat in life. These are all healthy ways and divine ways of partaking food. It is not the kind of a pollution or adulteration that comes. Even poison becomes navapashana, the nine consecrated foods that has been given to Krishna Bhagavan. Why does Krishna Bhagavan partake food during the Ashtami? In what way? How? Why do we as devotees give n number of food to Krishna Bhagavan? It is because He loves food. Why does He love food? He loves the way we have cooked it. We have cooked it with so much of devotion and love. That is the reason He offers back. Does He eat it? No, He doesn't eat it. He just gives it back with that blessed food, consecrated food, for us to eat as prasad. This is very important. All these factors are very, very vital for our enlightenment and realization. This is very, very important. So, from today or from tomorrow, make it a point. You don't watch TV while you are eating food. All your ill health will go away. In fact, if you have any ill health or if you have any kind of disease in your system, remember from today onwards, all your diseases can be cured by the kind of medicine you are taking. You will have a robust, healthy life from today. Just 10 minutes, that's all. Just 10 minutes of your time is required for your own healthy, better way of living, enlightened way of living. With this, let me bless you with the Divine Mother Sri Srinivasa's grace and blessings for your better health, prosperity and for peace of mind and for your own enrichment and enlightenment. Jai Mata.